everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the equation of the tangent plane. And in this one we've been given the function z equals x squared plus y squared, and we've been asked to find the tangent plane to that function at the point 3, 4, 25. So I've gone ahead and written out for us the equation of the tangent plane, the formula for the equation of the tangent plane, and it's more complicated than it looks more complicated than it is. Basically, we only need a couple pieces of information. First of all, we've already been given the point at which we're supposed to find the tangent plane, 3, 4, 25. Well, 3, 4, and 25 are going to go in for x sub 1, y sub 1, and z sub 1, respectively, right? We've got x sub 1, y sub 1, and z sub 1. So we already know those three pieces of information. We're going to leave z, x, and y in the final answer for the equation of the tangent plane. So we don't even have to do anything with those. So all we have left is the partial derivative with respect to x at the point P, right? All this means is we're going to take the partial derivative with respect to x and then plug in the point P. And then we also have to take the partial derivative with respect to y and plug in the point P, and that'll give us this whole piece of information. So we really only need those two things. So let's go ahead and take the partial derivatives of z with respect to x and y, then we'll plug in the point P to both of them, and then take all of our information and plug it into the formula for the equation of the tangent plane. So we'll take the partial derivative of z with respect to both x and y. So partial derivative of z with respect to y. Remember, when we're taking the partial derivative of z with respect to x, we'll be treating x as the variable and holding y constant. So when we take the derivative of x squared plus y squared, we'll get a derivative of 2x, because the derivative of x squared with respect to x is 2x. The derivative of y squared is 0 because there's no x variable involved in that term. Y is treated as a constant, so that whole term just becomes 0. Similarly, the derivative of z with respect to y is just going to be 2y because the derivative of x squared will be 0. The derivative of y squared will be 2y. So those are our partial derivatives. Now all we need to do is find the partial derivatives at the point P, at the point 3, 4, 25. So we would write that as the partial derivative of z with respect to x at the point 3, 4, 25. And all that tells us to do is plug in 3 for x, 4 for y, and 25 for z into our partial derivative here. Well, we've only got an x variable. We don't have y's or z's. So we only have to plug in 3 for x. So we'll get 2 times 3, which of course is just equal to 6. Similarly, the partial derivative of z with respect to y at the point 3, 4, 25, we only have the variable y left in our partial derivative, so we're just going to plug in 4 for y. We'll get 2 times 4, and therefore we'll get 8. So, given that, we can now plug in all of this information to our tangent plane formula. So, remember we said we were going to leave z as it is, so we'll get z minus z sub 1. Well, z sub 1 comes straight from our point P, right? Z sub 1. So we get z minus 25 is equal to the partial derivative of z with respect to x at the point P. Well, we solved for that and we got 6. So we plug in 6, and then we're going to multiply by x times x minus 1. Well, we know that x sub 1 is 3. So we get times x minus 3. And then the same thing for the second term. We add to that. We found that the partial derivative of z with respect to y at the point P was 8. So we plug in 8. And then we get times y minus y sub 1, which we already know from the point P to be 4. So we get y minus 4. We could leave our equation of the tangent plane in this form, or I think it's a little bit cleaner if we simplify. So we would get z minus 25 equals 6x minus 18 plus 8y minus 32. I'm going to try to get z by itself. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'll go ahead and leave the 25 for now. But we always want to write the term with the x variable in it first. So 6x, then the y variable, and then the constant. So 6x plus 8y, negative 18 minus 32 is a negative 50. And now we can go ahead and add 25 to both sides to get z on its own. And we'll get z equals 6x plus 8y, negative 50 plus 25 is a negative 25. So our final answer is z equals 6x plus 8y minus 25. And that's it. That's the equation of the tangent plane of this function z at the point P, which is 3, 4, 25. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!